There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with Derek Carr and the Oakland Raiders. Rodgers now on first down. Got a man. It's Tonyan complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. You ain't ready today. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Rodgers throwing quickly out to Adams. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. Throwing now is Rodgers. Open man is Allison, complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Rodgers to Allison, good for a Green Bay first down.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield to run up there and make that tackle, setting a tone early for his defense.
And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Oh, good night, baby. Good night.
Typically,
baby.
We think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down.
You better be afraid of me.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get them about 5 yards. Tyre Whitehead, top 10 in tackles last year, up to make the play.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
From the 24, Rodgers, and that's complete to Adams. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. And how about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
And this will be play number 8 of the opening drive. It's third and short. Now it's Rodgers. And this is going to be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the three.
Yeah, they had three first downs and 3 points. After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Shotgun now for Carr. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Zay Jones was the intended receiver, but it's going to be second down.
But that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. A quick throw there out to Williams. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Like Antonio Brown, Tyrell Williams came to the Raiders in March, came up the coast from L.A. where he caught 41 balls last year with the Chargers. His best year was 2016 when the Chargers were still in San Diego, over 1,000 yards, 7 touchdowns, and the Raiders really have high hopes for this 27-year-old receiver. A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and 5. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. On second down, Jacobs. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It goes as a loss of 6. And now third down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Trying to lay one up deep. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met. I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
They'll come up second and 6 now from the 24. We're doing it. back to the ground, this time with Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
12 yards there and a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Working from the gun, Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. Now the ball comes loose, and the Raiders pick it up. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. So after the fumble recovery, it's Carr. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option, and he'll only get a yard to bring up third and 1. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. Third down turns to first with that 5-yard pickup.
And that's why you spend a first-round draft pick on a running back. Not for just the fancy runs, let's go, let's go. But these dirty, gritty third and ones, third and twos. That's why you draft him.
On first down, they go with Jacobs again. Kevin King coming up from the secondary to make the play.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they were hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down now, Richard. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Now it looks like we've got a Raider here, slow to get up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. The Packers bringing in an extra member of the secondary here to try for the third down stop. From the gun, it's Carr. The open man here, Renfro. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. Monday, down. 185.
Now on first down, he's going to find and complete it to Renfro, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry, ball gets tipped in the air, because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Now, 280. Mike 42, check, Mike 42.
You ain't doing nothing,
though. Carr to throw again.
to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Fourth down, and on comes the Raider kicker, Daniel Carlson. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. The kick by Carlson is good, and that will tie us at 3-3. Last season for Carlson, bit of a strange rookie year, won the Vikings job, then was let go week two after going 0-3, but he picked things back up.
Remember, he was drafted to cure their kicking woes, and he ends up going 0-3 against Green Bay, including the potential game winner, gets cut, picked up by the Raiders, 16-17 the rest of the season. I'd say at the end of the year, a pretty good success story.
Field goals all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Here we go.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And we're under a minute to go here in what's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, you string them together, could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
Rodgers now on first down. And he's got Rome. And the Raiders are in for 6. Touchdown.
Nice touchdown, baby. Keep working.
Short throw, pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the lead is now 10-3. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here.
Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
Give him a couple on the catch. It's 2nd and 8.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Get him.
To throw again on 2nd down. Rodgers, he'll get this off to Jamal Williams. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Rodgers now hitting on 80% of his passes in the early going. 8 of 10. It's 1st down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling.
And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line.
Let's go.
Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. Rodgers now after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. Rodgers again now. The left side throw complete to Adams. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Rodgers will bring him up to the line, first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Rodgers going to throw. And he finds his tight end, Graham. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Nifty running there, but it'll come on what should be the final play of half number one. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They go with Washington to begin the drive. And he'll wind up with about 6 up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Carr gonna throw. And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down. Za'Darius Smith just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Carr. And this is caught, but I don't think he stayed in bounds. No, he didn't. It's incomplete. The throw took him past the boundary, and it's 4th. So good work there on the defensive side for the first drive of the second half.
Yeah, and until their offense can get into rhythm, their defensive players and staff have got to say to themselves, we've got to make it work. We've got to stand in here and make sure nothing else happens until our guys start moving the ball.
That'll be a 48-yard punt, 1 yard on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, 1st down and 10. So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number two. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know in the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll go again to Jones. And he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime means had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. The product of Jersey City, Tahir Whitehead on the sack.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Here's J.K. Scott now.
as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon.
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket.
And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the five. They'll spot it at the six-yard line. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
They'll start the drive to Washington. And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the five-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers. Neither side looks on track in the ground game. So the false start will back them up five. That's on the Raiders' big money man, the free agent tackle, Trent Brown. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Carter throw on third and one. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. Here's A.J. Cole now, standing just about on his own goal line. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Now Rodgers. Open here is Allison. That's complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 11 yards there. First down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Back-to-back good plays. Have them on the move on first down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And some space here. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
On second and 2, Rodgers, and he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. An 11-yard touchdown as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Extra point up and good by Crosby, and we are even at 10 apiece. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On first, here's Washington. Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of 5.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Now, this will probably be the last play of the quarter. He's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play. Back now at Lambeau. Knotted up here at 10. That's our score as we begin quarter number 4. The Raiders on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Now Carr. He's got a man open. It's Hunter Renfrow. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arc on it, he's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
On first down, Washington. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Give him 12 yards that time and an Oakland first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Operating from the gun, Carr. And this will be incomplete. They were trying to get it to DeAndre Washington, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
Certainly looked like maybe his 3rd or his 4th read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41.
What we got?
Throwing again, Carr. This will be caught, Tyrell Williams.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
The Raiders on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 6. To throw his car. He'll find his tight end. That's Waller. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. And they just keep marching right along. 1st down on a pickup of 8 there. Carr now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10. Again, it's Carr. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
That's where you belong.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Carr with a play fake to Jacobs. Complete to Washington. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a 3rd down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? 3rd and 4. Again, they'll throw with Carr. Got a man. It's complete. Williams. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on 3rd down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a 1st down.
Now a nice play defensively on 1st down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on 1st down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on 1st down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up 2nd down.
On 2nd down, it's Jacobs. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
Oh, yeah.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big 3rd down. They'll run with Jacobs. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. So a big one coming now for Daniel Carlson. This for the lead in the final stages. The kick by Carlson is good. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. Big kick right there to give them the lead in the 4th, but there is still time left for a final drive.
Did they score too soon? Post-game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they manage the clock exactly right.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So now Rodgers in the pack, down 13-10, a little under 1:50 remaining. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up 1st and 10. Aaron Rodgers, 3 fourth-quarter comebacks last year. That's the most he's had in one season in his entire career, and he's going to need another one right now. A nice-looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about since training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance.
A crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked by Darrell Worley. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. They hand off to their big tight end. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. And they will advance this across midfield, but still well shy of a first as he's tackled at the 47. They stop him after a gain of only four, and that brings up fourth down. Here's A.J. Cole now. He's been terrific so far. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. And he'll be upended after a gain of five, up to the 25-yard line. Five seconds, 4 seconds. One final try now for Rodgers. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still... You're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Lambeau.